And did anyone discuss jaundice with you during your pregnancy or immediately after birth?
Like immediately, yeah, immediately after. Yeah, but not during pregnancy, no.
I knew that jaundice made the child's eyes yellow.
The baby's on the yellow side. It's not, I forgot what it is, about the, something about the color.
Do you know anything about preventing or treating jaundice?
No.
Today we're going to talk about jaundice. You may have heard the term before, but do you really know what it is? When should you be concerned about jaundice, and how would you recognize it in your newborn? I'm Tara, a registered nurse here at the Monarch Center, and I'm joined by Dr. David Millar. He's the executive director and medical lead at the Monarch Center and a family physician. Welcome.
Thanks, Tara.
So can we start by just having a brief description about what jaundice is and how common it is in the newborn?
First of all, it's really common in the newborn period. And jaundice is the process by which the baby's skin and whites of the eyes turn yellow. And it either is happening because the bilirubin levels are too high and the bilirubin is building up in the body, or the bilirubin is not able to be excreted fast enough.
So what is bilirubin exactly?
It's a yellowish-brown substance which is formed as red blood cells and hemoglobin are being broken down by the body. And it is metabolized by the body and by the liver, and then turned into a form that can be excreted in the stool or in the urine.
So can jaundice or high bilirubin hurt the baby?
Generally it doesn't, first of all. And in most cases, jaundice is just a normal process. But if the levels of bilirubin become too high, and under certain conditions, if that bilirubin is able to penetrate into the brain, it can cause significant damage to the brain and significant neurological disease, such as developmental delays, cerebral palsy, deafness, and significant neurological disorders. And so we have a situation where it's very common and we want to recognize that, but also it can be very serious and we want to take it seriously.
So can you talk to us a little bit about the signs and symptoms of jaundice?
Yeah, jaundice usually shows up about 24 hours after the baby's born, and it starts with the yellowing of the white part of the baby's eyes and the face, and then it progresses downwards to the chest and then to the arms and legs after that. Babies who have more severe jaundice may seem really tired, and they may be hard to wake, and they may feed poorly. They also can fall asleep during feeds, but on the alternative side of that, they can also be very irritable and hard to soothe.
So how do we test for these bilirubin levels?
There's two ways generally. One is through a blood test called a total serum bilirubin or a neobilirubin, where the baby's heel is pricked and that blood is drawn and analyzed for bilirubin. The other way is through a little machine called a transcutaneous bilirubinometer, in which, in this case, there's no blood involved in this test, and the little machine is either held on the baby's chest or sometimes forehead, and it uses a wavelength of light in order to interpret the baby's bilirubin level and decide whether a blood test needs to be done.
And when are these bilirubin levels tested for?
Generally, they are tested at the 24-hour mark. Most hospitals will test at that point or before the baby goes home. If babies are born at home or go home before 24 hours, the bilirubin levels are typically tested after the 24-hour mark. That can be done either back at the hospital or at a community-based clinic that provides that service, such as Monarch Center.
Great. So what do we normally do about jaundice or if the baby has a high bilirubin level?
Most of the time, jaundice is treated strictly with just hydration and feeding. And in fact, all types of jaundice are treated with feeding and hydration. In some cases, we have to go beyond that and use other techniques such as phototherapy.
And what is phototherapy exactly?
Phototherapy is where we use a ultraviolet light, and that ultraviolet light changes the nature of the bilirubin so that it can be turned into a form that's more easily excreted by the body. And the ultraviolet light is provided either through a blanket, sometimes you'll see, especially in emergency departments, but also through a sort of fixed unit that most hospitals have, which will shine the light on the baby.
And this is most often done in the hospital?
Almost always done in a hospital, yeah.
So what can we do to prevent jaundice?
The best way to prevent jaundice is, again, feeding and hydration, which will allow the baby to produce stool and produce urine that can help to excrete the bilirubin.
And how often should a baby be feeding? You said that, I think.
Yeah, I mean, again, at the beginning, particularly in a jaundice baby, we want to feed the baby at least 8 times a day. And again, your healthcare provider will often suggest a shorter interval, so more like 10 or even 12 times a day.
Okay. So are some babies more likely to become jaundiced than others?
For sure. Babies that are born early or are small, so less than 38 weeks and less than 2.5 kilos would be at higher risk for jaundice. If the baby loses a lot of weight, we usually use 10% of the birth weight. The baby goes below 10% of its birth weight loss. That's a risk. If there's a mismatch between the mom and baby blood, so that there's antibodies in the baby, that can cause breakdown of red blood cells and hemoglobin, and that can cause jaundice as well. Lots of people have seen this, if there's bruising on the baby or swelling on the baby's head, that collection of blood, that blood can break down and cause jaundice as well. And then certain ethnicities as well can put you at risk for jaundice as well.
Can it run in families as well?
It definitely can run in families. In fact, if a sibling of the baby has had jaundice with phototherapy, we consider that a risk factor as well. Yeah.
So to recap, jaundice is common and usually tested for in the first 24 hours. It often resolves with really good feedings. However, some babies will require phototherapy treatment to prevent lifelong problems.
Exactly. It's really important to call your healthcare provider right away if your baby is refusing to eat, either at the breast or the bottle, if your baby is sleepy all the time, if your baby is losing a lot of weight, or if the jaundice is getting worse and is spreading from the face to the body and then to the arms and legs as well. Or if you have any other significant concerns about your baby, make sure you call your doctor or your health provider right away.
And I think for as parents, it's good to be informed, right? So essentially, you do need to read up on possibilities, and when someone is saying something to you, you know exactly what is going on, and that really helps.
Thanks so much, Dr. Millar.
Yeah, you're welcome.
So if you're concerned about your baby's jaundice, or if you're having trouble with feedings, please make sure to contact any of the resources listed here.